And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 3. Blind, I'm the RPG chick. Last episode, we checked out the Argus Row cluster. All the systems and war assets and planets therein. As well as the Hades Nexus. Ditto. So we've gone here. And where's Argus Row again? Here. So we have one or two more systems to check out that have been recently unveiled. Anna's Basin, I believe we did go to. Let me just... Yes, we did. It has one system called Pranus. And that's where we met the diplomatic ship. Way back when. Ethan cluster, yeah. Just don't want to miss anything. Silean Nebula is where we head for the fuel reactors. We have an N7 mission to do there. Side quest. Nimbus cluster we've done. Minos Wasteland. I don't know what's going on here. Okay, so the only new thing is the Silean Nebula. Minos Waste... let me go check this out. I don't know what the hell's over there. Array was where we had that mission. The Cerberus scientist mission, but... Why does it say we have to go there? Jellix. Let me just check, guys. Make sure that we don't land on any of these. It's flashing, but I don't know what we have to do here. We've already found all the assets. Unless it's just an error. Weird. P-tests. Equitus. Should I scan this or something? I don't know. I don't know why that's doing that. It's still flashing. Alright, let's hit the Silean Nebula. We got fuel, nice. Before we buy fuel, let me see if we can find any fuel. I was checking the... So this Kiplodon system. We got Tropae here. Aware that it only takes one weaponized asteroid to destroy the fueling station at Sion, the Asari seeded the asteroid belt in the system with a warning network of sensors and spy drones. The system's brains are server clusters at the equidistant asteroids Tropae, Lokia, and Nili. But unobstructed lines of sight are still of little use in spotting incoming Reaper ships traveling at faster than light speeds. True that. True that. Let's check out these planets. Hanalei. Sounds like something off the coast of Hawaii. Early surveyors of Hanalei dismissed its resource potential, saying it had more heat than a planet needs and more argon than a galaxy would buy. As an enormous terrestrial planet buried under a merciless atmosphere of argon, nitrogen, and carbon dioxide, Hanalei hosted only small orbital stations that were primarily scientific in nature. The facilities have since been destroyed by the Reapers. Sorry guys, I'm pausing to cough and stuff like that. Kate Catabolo? Catabolo is a relatively large methane ammonia ice giant, although Sione and its orbital stations offer military-grade starship fuel. Commercial ships took advantage of the helium-3 refineries here. Because Catabolo was relatively near to the mass relay in the system, the Reapers destroyed the infrastructure on their way to more important targets. See if I can find any goodies. There might not be goodies. But we will look for them nonetheless. If I can find fuel, I don't have to buy fuel. Oops. One thing I'm sure, I think there were a lot more refueling stations in Mass Effect 2, I believe. Seems few and far between here. Is this another one here? Oh. Were the other asteroids they were talking about, were they destroyed? Okay, not finding anything. Let me just read the description of Sione. We won't go next yet because I want to check out all these other systems first. This garden world's claim to military fame is that it was assaulted repeatedly during the Krogan rebellions, but never occupied by more than token forces. The Asari cut off the Krogan supply line at the Citadel Relay and drove the invaders out. Today, antimatter generators on the surface and in orbital stations provide fuel for military starships throughout Asari space. The matriarchs defending the planet today have vowed to maintain Sione's legacy. They pledge it will fall to no enemy, organic or synthetic. Colony founded in 322 CE, population is 260 million, capital is Polos. Okay, we're not going there yet, as stated. Okay, we're not being...
Signal confirmed.
Reapers are not coming, so something on Hanalei. Here. Probe launched. Oh, we found an asset, Dr. Jaliz. Whoever the hell that is. Now we'll check out these assets eventually, guys. 100% recovered. Okay, we can go to the next system. Let's buy fuel, I guess. We'll make our way around, at least. We'll see how much fuel we have left at Fontes if we can head there and back. will clockwise go to Laropi. Oh, there's some here. Oh, some wreckage. Cool. A planet hang out in the middle of nowhere. Check out this gas giant first. Paphos. Paphos, a hydrogen-helium gas giant with a significant amount of nitrogen, is named for a prominent Asari lawgiver. Her treatise on the reluctance of democracies to go to war with other democracies formed a key tenet of Asari political theory that led to Thessia's modern golden age. The planet itself was only notable for orbital stations that fueled transport ships by skimming deuterium and helium-3. The Reapers destroyed the stations, killing the inhabitants. Those metal bastards. Let's check out the asteroid belt. There's something glowing there, but no, nothing. Okay, we've got Yacilium. Yacilium is a minor rock planet that has not quite cleared the ring of debris at the edge of Laropi's orbits. It is believed to be an extrasolar capture. For several centuries, Yacilium supported a succession of mining colonies, first iridium, then titanium, and finally light metals like bauxite and alumina. The planet was abandoned long before the Reaper invasion. Well, good for them. Hopefully they're somewhere a little bit safer. Not that anywhere is really safe from the Reapers. Check out this wreckage. The Asari once had enormous solar collectors around the bluish-white AOV star Laropi. A0V? Using the star's considerable heat to create antiprotons for military starship fuel. Now, all that can be detected is scrap. Reapers emerged from dark space near the Silean Nebula cluster and established a front in Laropi's system. The Asari fleet that guarded what used to be known as Espota Station cannot be found. It is scattered and destroyed. One can only hope that the backup reactors in the Kipladon system do not fall, or the Asari fleet will have precious little fuel. Alright. Goodies, perhaps? Looking for fuel. Which will help us continue on, so we don't have to go head back to the other system to fuel up and spend money. I think we're down around here somewhere. And you know I'm going to scan the wreckage. Whoop! Now if I go here...
I found something.
We can hit both. Just a little bit, okay. 300 units. We're full. Nice. 50%. So this wreckage, nothing? How about here? Let's scan here first, because something's going to come from there. Hold up. Probe launched. Armali sniper unit. Cool. We have a lot of assets to check out when we're done. 100% done. Yay! Laropi complete. Now, Nahuala. If I'm saying that right. Okay. Let's check out this. This is a really small system. Check out the asteroid belt. Okay. Egesia. Rife with volcanic activity and scorched by the nearby orange star, Nahuala, Egesia is an unforgiving and ever-shifting puzzle box of a planet. Ceaseless solar winds and magnetic bombardment have thinned Egesia's atmosphere, but these features are actually a boon in wartime. Powerful magnetic fields and large quantities of airborne volcanic ash make many forms of scanning difficult, allowing the Asari to hide valuable palladium and molybdenum mines needed for the war effort. Agessia's sheltered underground colonies remain untouched by the Reapers, at least for the moment. You leave those alone, you bastards. Hyatiana? Hyatiana serves as a bastion of research for the Asari, boasting multiple observation outposts, glacial drilling stations, and educational institutions. While the planet's average temperature hovers near freezing, the equatorial band contains oceans and many freshwater rivers. Xenobiologists of all stripes often visited the planet, as its expansive facilities were a haven for the life scientists. The Reapers destroyed Hyatiana's spaceports and its uniformed defense forces. As with other Asari planets, the Reapers forced a heavily biotic population into surrender through threats of massive retaliation rather than assault by husks alone. Colony founded in 735 CE, population 119 million, pre-invasion, capital city is Port Larama. And finally, Phoros. Phoros is a hydrogen gas giant tinted orange by swirling bands of ammonia and sulfur. Its four moons hosted small spaceports used to mine the moons and the nearby Halimar asteroid belt. Unfortunately, Phoros was an easy target of the Reapers. They made short work of the lunar outposts. On sensors, no survivors or Reaper forces are immediately obvious, but Phoros's ring system is filled with dust and ice that would allow concealment. Population is 43,700, pre-invasion. Alright, let's look for fuel. So I wonder if these are the last batch of systems or clusters that have yet to be unveiled after every... Seems to be the main quest. Whenever we finish something in the main quest, they may or may not be a system uncovered. Like, we really didn't know they existed until then, you know? Ah!
Signal confirmed.
Jeez. 250 units. We are full. 50% recovered. Hold up. They're all coming from the top, it seems. I want to leave that way, because that's where I am. Sometimes you hear a vague static. Probe away. We found Ceres Guard. Aren't they an armament or armor manufacturer? Oh, really? It stops here. The Reapers are like, you know, we really should check out that system. Nah, you know what? Maybe not, but let's keep a close eye on it. Anyway, we found everything, which I am happy about. Doing really well. Fontes system. These are close together, luckily. It's a moon, I'm guessing. Oh my. Lenormund's scorching hot surface is composed of lime with deposits of copper. It has faint traces of a nitrogen atmosphere. The Elcor have left it untouched, aside from orbital probes that monitor the planet, in case anything noteworthy should one day occur. This is an Elcor system? Oh, Dacuna. We're supposed to go to Dacuna for something. Right, there's something we'll have to find there. Yeah, I want to check the journal about that, too. The Alcor homeworld Dakuna overflows with natural resources protected by law, from large deposits of precious metals to vast forests. The Alcor themselves lived in rich grasslands near the equator. The majority of Dakuna's settlements are tucked within this belt, as the conservative Alcor feel little desire to build outside their comfort zone. Their twin capitals are from migrations from the wet season to the dry season, a tradition made obsolete by modern technology but still observed. After the destruction of the Alcor Navy, Reapers moved in their ground troops to occupy the cities. This has taken longer than most civilized worlds, as the Alcor have spread out into smaller distant settlements, reflecting their preference for close-knit family communities instead of densely packed cities. Population 2.35 billion pre-invasion. Capitals are Saroon and Malvuan. Ultan, the moon of Dakuna. The first mission to Ultan, Dakuna's moon, was a century in the making. Alcor leaders felt resources for space travel could be better used on their home world, and it took decades of persuasion to secure project funding. Yeah, sounds like Earth. Archaic harvesting stations that recovered helium-3 from the moon's regolith were still functioning when the Reapers invaded, and the Alcor station there were able to flee the system. Stuff. Dakuna. Check that out. That's a star behind there. I thought that was a planet. Talun. Talun is named after the first Alcor settlement in recorded history. The planet's name roughly translates to the deep and restful meadowland, which is somewhat of a misnomer. Given that Taluna's thick-crushing atmosphere keeps its surface boiling hot, and the air is a noxious mixture of carbon dioxide and helium. Yeah, well. And gas giant. Sengal. When Dakuna's government learned that the Reapers had returned, they evacuated everyone on Sengal's helium-3 recovery platforms. The sizable hydrogen-helium gas giant was abandoned, its workers relocated to Dakuna. The move was ostensibly made because the Alcor homeworld was a more defensible position. In reality, it may have been motivated by a subconscious herding instinct, as most grazing creatures come together in large groups when predators near. Safety in numbers, you know. Let's check out the atmosphere. Asteroid belt. Nothing there. Let me just take a look. Here. We have something called Dakuna. I think. I thought we did. Dakuna, Code of the Ancients. Recover the holy book from Dakuna and return it to him at Purgatory. Okay. So, whoops. Just want to see if we can find some fuel, and obviously we're going to scan Dakuna. Whoop! Sorry guys. Hope I didn't blast anyone out listening with headphones.
I found something.
175 units. That's enough for us. Well, if we squeeze between here and get out that way. Oh, there's two? Don't! No, there's two! I gotta get both. I'm not leaving the top. I'm gonna try to head down to the bottom or south or whatever that would be. We found it. The Code of the Ancients. They're coming slow so far. Hopefully this is the last artifact or whatever thing to find. Probe launched. The Elcor Flotilla. Awesome. I didn't know they had their own flotilla as well. 100% done. Yay! Let's get the hell out of here! Yay!
Faster than light jump successful.
Alright, we're full with fuel. Let's go to this distant Taolia system. Oh my. Takes almost half our fuel just to get there. Okay, four planets. First is Loxia. Loxia is a small terrestrial planet tidally locked to Taolia. Due to its low mass and relatively small size, Loxia has an exceptionally fast stellar orbit. The planet's light atmosphere consists mainly of argon and krypton, which occasionally produces long, thin bands of luminescence along the twilight border. Loxia's crust is mainly igneous rock with wide salt flats and occasional deposits of potassium. Nevos. First discovered by Asari pioneers in 430 CE, Nevos is a vibrant garden planet and home to a thriving Asari colony. Sandy beaches and romantic twin moons fuel a bustling tourism economy, while practical and secretive corporate matters are handled in spiraling arcologies built along towering cliffs. Even though it has been colonized for centuries, Nevos feels a frontier away from regulation and oversight. Consequently, a number of influential political lobbies have established sizable presences on the planet. Colony founded in 430 CE, population 677 million, capital is Estella. Like a star. Quirezia. A typical hydrogen-helium gas giant, Quirezia serves as a naval resource for fuel gathering and magnetic field discharge. The planet is surrounded by a band of seven large moons that form the necklace, a reference to a legendary jewel owned by the ancient Asari queen for which Quirezia was named. Quirezia's orbit places it within the system's frost line, where gas giants do not usually form. For this reason, the planet is believed to be an extrasolar capture. The alternative, that its orbit is decaying, is a horrifying prospect to the tourism and immigration boards of Nevos, since they would be in the gas giant's eventual path. Yeah, that would not be good. Last planet. Adabolos. Farthest out from Taolia, Adabolos is a low-density planet peppered with outdated mining facilities and a few independent mechanical contractors. The unmanned mining scouts that first surveyed the planet conveyed positive reports based on a light gravity, gentle atmospheric pressure, and easy penetrable crust of silica and salt. Neither methane pockets nor low temperatures were barriers to the Asari, but after centuries of mining, the veins of genuinely valuable materials are gone, and all but a few inhabitants have departed. Excuse me. Cool. Checked out all the planets. See if we can find some fuel here to continue on. Wait.
Signal confirmed.
375 units of fuel. They knew we'd need a good amount. Okay, so luckily all the Reapers would come from that direction. Hopefully this is the last one, and it will be done. Probe launched. We found the rings of a loon, which is the other thing we need to get. 66%. What? Wait. One more. Gotta catch 'em all. Asset mon. Credits recovered? Really? It's the first I've ever seen it. Found credits instead. 100%, yay!
Evasion successful.
Can I... I can't pan out to see... We're supposed to go this way. Trying to head straight to our target, but it was... not panned out enough. So I'm just gonna fuel up here. Right. This is a good episode length. So yeah, that was what? The Silean Nebula? I believe. I can't remember the name of it. Keep going. Yep, Silean Nebula. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time. We check out the N7 fuel reactors mission. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.